गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, MG 8591 प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, फोर्थ ईयर, सेवन्थ सेमेस्टर, यूनिट वन, इंट्रोडक्शन टू मैनेजमेंट एंड आवर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. टॉपिक नाइन करंट ट्रेंड्स एंड इश्यूज इन मैनेजमेंट. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू लेसन, आई हैव अ प्रॉब्लम एंड क्वेरी एंड गिव जस्टिफाई अबाउट द प्रॉब्लम. So this is a problem statement. So the problem statement based on Atul Jain as a regional sales head in the export division of a FMCG, the fast moving consumer goods company. In a department meeting, he asked one of the subordinate Manik to take charge of the company new office in Dubai. He allocates the work to him and grants the necessary authority. However, within a month by seeking regular feedback on the extent of work accomplishment from Manik, Hadur realized that the Manik is not doing work as per his expectation. So he takes away the authority of delegate to him and re-delegates the work to Pragit due to time waste in the switchover. The work at the Dubai office suffer tremendously and company is not able to meet its desired goals. This is a problem. Why is Manik supposed to give regular feedback about work to Atul? Justify your answer. So this is the answer. The Manik is supposed to give the regular feedback about the work to Atul, as he has been granted authority and an interest responsibility, so he remaining answerable for the outcome. Okay, so this is issues in going on industry. So you give a feedback, you can whatever we are lacking in your organization, after you can improve and attain your goal based on that one. If not give a feedback, not improve your organization, attain the goal or objective in your industry, so that we can go for current issues. So current issues, current trends and issues in management. So next one, current trends and issues management. So we have globalization, work ethics, workforce diversity, entrepreneurship, e-business, knowledgeable management, learning of organization and quality management. This is a current trends and issues in management. Suppose I am a manager, a manager, my subordinate suppose going out, the new subordinate joined my team. I have explained starting process to ending process. Suppose some of you not going to outside, no need explain. Okay, so this is a issues in industries. So whatever may be, I have technically strong and technically strong and skill oriented people, no need explanation. He will join our industry and execute my plan accordingly in timely manner. That is the industry needed that for peoples. So first one, we go for globalization. So globalization based on management in international organization and political and cultural challenges of operating in a global market. So industries need expert, what is my place in global market? So this is an expectation from industry, so that in the industries industry can improve, we can attain that global market. If your organization performance is very low, you could not attain global market, so that you can strongly work out in your industries. So working with the people from different cultures and coping with the and capabilities backlash and movement of jobs to country with the low cost labors, this is a globalization of our industries. The next one, the ethics. It is increase the emphasis on ethics education in college curriculums. So increase the creations of use of code of ethics by business. Suppose you can unethically, you can, I'm a manager, I'm use you know about rules and regulation and ethically process, and whatever ethically process I know very well. If not, I'm not know, I'm a first learn, after learn and after start the process. Suppose I'm implement unethically, I'm not following ethically process, means I would not attain even my goal. That is my response, that is not my responsibility. Okay, so that whatever ethically you can implement at your organization, as well as your organization can improve and attain your goal. So that increase the creation and use of code and ethics by business. A process for addressing ethical dilemma. For example, what is the ethical dilemma? Who are the affected stakeholders? What personals, organizational, external factors are important to my decision? What are the possible alternatives? These are, you can identify your industry, you can improve your organization, and as well as attain your goal. Okay, so for example, you know about ethics means motivation, faith, integrity, respect, responsibility, value, equality, social, treated, truth, etiquette, moral, character, philosophy, decency. So these are all always are called ethics in your industry. So these are available in your industry, you can improve your, automatically your organization and top level in the market. Next one. The next one is the workforce diversity. The increasing heterogeneity in the workforce and more gender and minority ethics and other forms of diversity in employee. So you don't give a partiality to work your industry in the work environment. If you give a partiality, means the employees cannot work in your industry, so could not improve your organization. So don't give any partiality for subordinates, workers, and low-level employees. So aging workforce, older employees who work longer and do not retire. So old employees who work longer and do not retire. For example, my cousin or anybody working in industry in 13 years. So performance very well, you can adopt it. If not performance well, you cannot fit and move on to any other places. This is happened with industry expectation. For example, your skillful people are technologically oriented or communication oriented or driven. Means whatever you have given to you, assigned to you, can complete within a timely manner in your sectors. And increase the cost of public and private benefit for older workers, and increasing demand for product and services related to aging in your process. This is a workforce diversity in the process. The next one, entrepreneurship. So entrepreneurship is defined the process of starting a new business, and generally in response to opportunity. So, example, my friend is quit the job. He will start the startup. No problem. I have supported that one. We can good improve our organization and profit. This is based on entrepreneurships. An entrepreneur process pursue opportunity, innovation in the product and services or business method, and desire for continual growth of the organization. So Tilak Mehta is a 13 years old and one of the youngest entrepreneur in India. So he is the best. Tilak Mehta is a 13 years old, one of the youngest entrepreneur in India. So he is a 13 age, he is an entrepreneur. So you are all becoming a, and future you are entrepreneur. Don't go to any job. You can start your startup, innovation product, you can achieve your goal and obtain your project in your industry or institution or any other places. Next one, e-business. This is called electronic business. So this work performed by organization using electronic linkage to its key constituency, e-commerce, the sales and marketing aspects of an e-business. Category of e-business: e-business enhanced organization, e-business enabled organization, and total e-business organization. These are called e-business in your system. For example, like Amazon, Flipkart, these are all e-business oriented process. And another one example, GoDaddy. This is a website oriented. GoDaddy. Another one, Web6. Sorry. Another one means example. Google, example Google Meet, Great Learning. This is a e-business in the market. So yearly its turnover is very low, very huge amount of process, huge amount of amount received from based on only e-business in India as well as other countries. So that e-business is very perfectly going on day to day, increase the product based on revenue based on that product. Next one, learning organization and knowledge management. So learning organization based on focus on assessment, coaching, best practices, technology, fluid curriculum. In older days we using a blackboard. Now we commercialized in using of Cisco Webex. The classes handling using a Cisco Webex, Zoom, and Google Meet. These are all learning organization for technology oriented in learning culture of learning organization. So organization that has developed by capacity of continually learn and adapt and change the environment in the system. And knowledge management is based on cultivation of learning culture where organizational members systematically gather and share the knowledge with the other in order to achieve the better performance, so that you can attain your knowledge management. For example, first establish your objective. So I'm starting my industry. First I would establish my objective. What are the objectives? You can list out in your industry. After prepare for changes my objective and define high level process. What are the needs? What are the needs to develop and start up my organization? These are some questionnaire for knowledge management. After prior decision need of procurement. Suppose I start the organization means what are the needs I can define in requirement analysis. After design my plan. After implement my plan. After testing of my plan and produce my quantity based on customer oriented. After time my goal and increase my property as well as my performance can increase for my organization. And after measures in improvement, implementation, build up roadmap, assess the current status of these based on knowledge management. The cultivation of the learning culture where organization members systematically gather and share a knowledge with the other in order to achieve the better performance. These are all knowledge management in our process in the system. So next one, quality management. The quality management based on customer focus, leadership, engagement people, process approaches, improvement, evidence based on decision making, relationship management, customer area. So these are quality management principles. A philosophy of management driven by continual improvement in the quality of work process, responding to the customer needs expectation. Inspired by the total quality management is Deming and Zuran. Both of you define based on your quality in your system. The quality is not directly related to the cost. The poor quality result in lower product. This is Zuran and Deming of the statement of the management system in the quality. So for example, I'm a manager. First, engagement of the people. After define your process approaches and improvement of as well as my employee and after product. and evidence based on decision making. If any deviation of the my plan, first ask the my colleague and analyze it after implemented my systems. After relation my management, after customer focused on my product to delivery within time period and execute my systems. This is a quality management without any error corrections. This is the important of quality management. This is called Zoran defined quality is not directly related to cost. Poor quality result in a lower productivity. Suppose I am poor quality, my product's poor quality is automatically decrease from my productivity as well as my cost can be increased in our system. So that each and every product is managers has a whole responsibility to take care of that one to implement in industries. This is an activity. This is current trends and issues in the management. This is advantages. So I improve organization agility, better and faster decision making, quicker problem solving, increase the rate of innovation, supported employee and growth and development, sharing of the specialist expertization and better communication, improve business process. These are all advantages of my systems. This is the disadvantages of disadvantages. So finding a way to efficiently capture and record business knowledge and making information and resources easier to find, motivate the people to share, reuse and apply the knowledge consistently, and aligning knowledge management with the overall goals and business strategy, choosing and implementing the knowledge management technology, integrate knowledge management into existing processes and information systems. These are all disadvantages of current issues and current trends and issues management. So next assessment, list out the advantage of current trends and issues in management. Identify the disadvantages of current trends and issues in the management. This is references.